Then it's time to click next turn. Soviet Union attacked somewhere. Ivan Konev attacked our army. Carl von Rundstedt. They attacked a great army and a smaller army. They attacked our first great army. Yeah. Do they have? They have 900. They have 954 men. Right, they have two Jack 9 units, and they have two units of Jack 9 fighter planes. Then they have some infantry and some T-34 tanks and one MS-1 tank. Alright. Let's save the game in case I didn't do that. We will fight this battle, we won't retreat. So that's it. Army is still strong, even if it lost a lot of planes in the last battle that it fought. Start deployment. We have a general's bodyguard. Loose formation for him. Let's move him back. Well, the infantry will be loose formation and in guard mode. The infantry will just be sacrificed. Well, the general will actually retreat from the battle. I don't see why we should waste him. Interesting climate here. The units look red. Like they glow red. Had some assault infantry here. Jeeps. Jeep bodyguards. So this was a stronger force. Mix between starting armies and other units. They even had planes. But nothing we haven't faced before. Our Messerschmitt 109 planes are about to start firing on them. And fight their planes. I believe it's a dogfight now between our fighter planes and theirs. We have lots of planes. Will hopefully gain air superiority here. So the airplanes are simply not enough in numbers. We even have some Stuka bombers to bomb their tanks with. Alright, and we have the army here behind. It wasn't as strong. It had mostly BMW motorcycles and Panzer I tanks. And a Jeep, of course. A Jeep bodyguard. But they have this new unit added to the army. The anti-aircraft truck. They can fight on land units as well. I mean, they can fire on land units as well. They are supposed to fight the planes. I think they are pretty cool. And some infantry. Here the fight between the planes are going on. Our tanks are moving around. They move forward their infantry. We already killed a lot of their infantry. With the planes. There are MS-1 tanks here. they have pretty good armor, they were surprisingly good as for their armor. They don't have a lot of damage, fortunately. So our general is retreated, and our riflemen have been defeated. Enemy general fallen, Igor Ivanov is dead. Our trucks are firing. They have a unique sound. So we have lots of infantry still. The tanks here are broken. Some of our planes have been shot down. They don't have any planes left. They have one left here. Did a dive. They didn't go down. They have more than one plane left. They have a lot of planes left. Hope my planes will take them down before they are shot down from the sky by the tanks or something. Anyway. Panzer 1s here too, fighting their stuff, their infantry and tanks. Let's look at the statistics. 20% allies killed, 41% enemies killed. So we have lost 20% and they have lost about 40%. Right, so we are leading this. It's good, we will win again. Because they have quite the armies still standing, I believe. Taking into account that they can also recruit stuff. Just as we can, so. Oh, we have a moon there in the sky. Good job, Air Force of the Luftwaffe. You've taken down their planes now, I think. Alright, but we lost probably more than half of the planes. Just to make sure there are no one standing. Yeah, there seem to be no Yak 9 planes in the sky anymore. They also took down a lot of other stuff like tanks. The Stukas are bombing tanks on the ground. Battle event better than expected. I was worried for a while that the Yak 9 planes would actually be able to to win, even though we had a numerical advantage in the sky, because the tanks seemed to take out my planes. We only have 3 Jeeps left. Right. Continue the battle. Jetzt ist es Zeit, die Schweine zu zerquetschen. 22% allies killed and 79%, 80% enemies killed. We need them to be 85% so they won't have troops left after the battle. They are retreating with some of their units. One unit there. More Jeeps than MC motorcycles there.
Reich hat seine Überlegenheit durch diesen Sieg bestätigt.
And we won. Clear victory, Ernst Diesel, 105 men killed, 0, 68 remaining. Gadwon Rundstedt, 580 men killed, 787, that was very good. Mostly thanks to the planes, have 454 remaining. Ivan Konev of the Soviet Union, the enemy army, had 954 men, 152 kills, and 156 remaining of his army. That wasn't as good. Alright, and here's the detailed statistics. Hellis Onas, Mamurus Shiganitsu, Japanese foreign minister's comments at the capture of Saipan, June 1944. They attacked again with another army, and they attacked the same German troop. So Gerd Rundstedt and Ernst Diesel were attacked immediately after their victory by another Soviet army. It's comprised mostly of infantry, thankfully, riflemen. They also have some MS-1 tanks and T-34s as usual. They have a remnant of Jack-9 planes. And a new, fresh unit of Jack-9 planes. They have some snipers, some assault infantry, and they have a Katyusha rocket truck. They are dangerous. Maybe even more dangerous than the planes. We'll see. If you look at the statistics, we still have the advantage. I didn't get a chance to merge my troops. Let's save the game in case it will crash. Fight that battle as well. So they had enough armies to attack immediately after the other was defeated. Alright, like the second wave. I wonder if they will send a third wave or a fourth wave or even a fifth wave. It's possible they have at least three full armies down there. Alright, let's fight the battle again. Or the new battle. Germany has concluded a non-aggression pact with Poland. We shall adhere to it unconditionally. We recognize Poland as the home of a great and nationally conscious people. Adolf Hitler, 21st May 1935. And then in September the 1st, 1939, he broke everything he said here and attacked Poland. Alright, start deployment. Put in guard mode and loose formation and start the battle. The general will be retreated. Won't waste him. We have reinforcements arriving. Under Gerd von Rundstedt. Right, here we have the rocket trucks. Their most dangerous unit in this army. We also have some planes. Second most dangerous unit. We had two units, but one were at full strength. The other one was a remnant. Already firing the rocket trucks from the Katyusha rockets. And our army is arriving with lots of planes. I believe the rockets can take down planes. That's why I'm worried. We have some Stuka bombers, but they are not that many. We have a lot more of the fighter planes. The Messerschmitt 109 fighter planes. They are firing upon their infantry already. And tanks. Hope they will be able to take out their rocket trucks. The only unit that can swing the battle in Soviets' favor. One plane is already down. I don't know if it's mine or theirs. Probably mine. Dogfighting has started between the fighter planes. while simultaneously the rocket trucks are firing our troops and stuff. We have some jeeps with Gerd von Rundstedt himself arriving there. Our Panzerwands coming in from behind. We have some infantry at the far back of the army. The final units of the army are made up of infantry. We have some anti-aircraft trucks. Will be handy against their aircraft, but also against other units. Our BMW motorcycle going wild here. Not many left. Few of them left. We've taken out one of the trucks here. MS-1 tank there. I zoom in to see the chaos from the ground here. One of our planes lay on the ground there. And another one, two, and three. We've taken down quite a few of our planes. Mostly Stukas, I believe. Dogfighting is heavy in the air. The aircraft trucks are also firing. And the jeeps with their machine guns. Some tanks left and rockets. The rocket trucks are on a hill, standing with their backs towards the army but still firing at them. Statistics, we have lost 6%, they have lost 63%. So I think we will win this, we'll see. That we focused on planes, because had we focused on tanks, we wouldn't have been this superior in the battle. So air superiority is really important. Stukas are dropping bombs on targets. Still have the rocket trucks. At least three of them are still alive. Come on, Stukas, bomb the shit out of those rocket trucks. They're the only thing that can ruin this battle. We took down at least two of them. All three of them. Good job, Stuka bombers. Without the trucks, they can't win. Still have some fighter planes in the air. We heavily outnumber them. Maybe. I don't think they can win now. Troops here, assault infantry moving forward. Some riflemen. Lots of dead bodies on the battlefield now. The aircraft trucks firing towards the enemy planes in the sky. One enemy plane at least in the sky. One Jack 9 fighter plane. rest of their army been destroyed. There he had another one. They had two planes in the sky. Continued battle. 81% enemies killed, 60% allies killed. They need to take down some more of them. He took down both of their planes, I think. We have a general's bodyguard jeep. Probably Guard von Rundstedt himself. Retreating infantry there. And we won! The battle is ours! Alright, we had clear air superiority. So, Guard von Rundstedt, 427 men, killed 609. Not as many as in the previous battle, but still a lot, and more than he had himself. Men remaining 322. Captain Evans, they only had a captain this time, no general. Had 715 men, killed 75, that's bad. 92 remaining. Alright. And this is the detailed stats deck. Yeah. I've already read this recently. If they have a third army to throw our way. No crash, that's good. Ah, a third army. Under General Grigory Ivanov. Let's take a look at their army. So he has some infantry. Has 5 units of riflemen. 1 unit of scout snipers. 1 unit of assault infantry. 3 units of T-34 tanks, 1 unit of MS-1 tanks, and 1 unit of Jack-9 fighter planes, and a bodyguard of riflemen. Alright. Bad army, but it's the third army that threw our way. Our army is getting weaker after each battle, of course. And we haven't had the opportunity to merge the units. Which means they should be thin compared to in the beginning. Alright, let's wait a second. It's not how to say key. We'll replace that one. Yes. And we will fight this battle too, because it's part of the same they are attacking in waves. We click next turn and they attacked with one army, we defeated it, and then they attacked again with another one, we defeated it, and now they attacked with a third one. So we will fight this battle as well, the third wave. This is not the end, it is not even the beginning of the end, but it is perhaps the end of the beginning. Winston Churchill, 10th November 1942. So the third wave of Soviet armies, will we be able to destroy it as well? Let's move the bodyguard back and place in loose formation. The riflemen will be in loose formation and just be on guard mode. They had 81 men and all of them survived the first wave. In the second attack by the second Soviet army, they lost half their men. They only have 43 left. Right. We will retreat the general again. And the riflemen will just stand there. We have some reinforcements coming. And Guard von Rundstedt again. Here's their army, Soviet army. Mostly infantry this time around. But also some tanks. Hopefully no planes. I don't think they had any planes this time. Which gives us the air superiority. No, they had some Jack-9 remnants here, Jack-9 fighters, but we have more, so I believe we will win this. We have some Stuka bombers still in the air, 3 Stuka planes, lots of Messerschmitt 109 fighter planes. Still superior in numbers than their planes. Have the anti-aircraft trucks arriving there. Some jeeps with the general himself, some assault infantry, BMW motorcycles, riflemen, more riflemen, and even more riflemen. Alright, 4 units of riflemen at least. So our planes are dominating the airspace over the battlefield. That's why we will win. Stukas are bombing shit out of their infantry here. We lost the plane, I believe. Good job, Stuka bomber. They need to bomb their forces as they run away. Alright, we have tanks on the ground, Soviet tanks. But they are sitting ducks for our Stuka bombers. Let's see here, 5%, 6%, 6% allies killed, 10% enemies killed, 7% allies killed. Alright, we are getting weaker, but for each battle, but we have also seen that we don't need as many armies as they have to win. We just need better armies. If you have many armies of infantry, for example, they would all get slaughtered by one Soviet army, probably. If you have armies with lots of planes and tanks, then we could beat many Soviet armies with just one army. They have some MS-1 tanks in the back here, attacking our riflemen. They are now retreating. It's my riflemen there. 12 right left. So the MS-1 tanks took them out. We have some assault infantry here. And riflemen of their own. Our BMW motorcycles are charging their infantry. Firing at them while also driving them over. We are trying to fire back at the motorcycle crews. We also have lots of Messerschmitt 109 planes in the air, firing down on them. They can't do much to defend themselves against the planes. They've taken out 3 armies, that's great. Air superiority meant a lot. AI will also use lots of planes in the late game, so it's not like the AI will be stupid enough not to do it. The Rome Total War AI can feel what unit is good and what unit is bad, so the Rome Total War AI will actually use the good units when they can get them. He just had a lot of starting armies with T-34 tanks and riflemen generals. All the starting generals were riflemen bodyguards, with the exception of the historical ones like Shrukov or Stalin. And we won soon, at least. They probably said that the battle is going well. Allies killed 80%, enemies killed 84%. So, enemy general is dead. Grigory Ivanov died. Their infantry is retreating from our BMW motorcycles, and most likely from the planes. They're having a field day firing at them. Our infantry can easily move forward. See the statistics again. 91% of them are killed. We could have exited the battle. But well, we decided to continue it. And we won the battle! Clear victory! Ernst Diesel, men deployed 59, killed 0, men remaining 31. So they only lost men, they didn't do any good, but that's just a rifleman unit. Gerd von Rundstedt had 314 men in this battle, so his numbers are steadily decreasing. He killed 561, so he still killed more than he had, and 279 remaining now. The enemy army under Grigory Ivanov had 633 men, killed 69 and have 50 remaining. Alright. Here's the detailed statistic. I have returned many times to honor the valiant men who died. Every man who set foot on Omaha Beach was a hero. Lieutenant General Omar Bradley, commander of the US First Army, speaking after the war. Alright. And no crash. Good. Very good. I hate when I have to, you know, replay battles because of a crash. So they attacked three times in three waves. This army. Let's just combine these troops. So we have merged the force there. Have an army there. Stokes mortar artillery. Could actually be moved to the army as well. We have a strong force inside of Brest. The generals Ivan Konev and Georgi Ivanov. They have only stuff that we have already seen there. Many tanks. So they are not to be underestimated. This army. Let's see if we move the spy down there. Here we have Leonid Petrov and Alexander Petrov. We have faced them before. Their army, lots of infantry and tanks and some planes. Another army is here, outside Kyiv. It has the general Kirill Ivanov and Dmitry Ivanov and probably a secret general. And they have some tanks, T-34s, etc. Alright. So they still have quite a few armies. Can't move the spy anymore. Otherwise I would have moved her up here. They have a small force of Soviets there. So let's just beat it back. In Minsk they don't have a lot of troops. Resolve. And they died here. Could attack Minsk. Ernst Dissel, enemy army routes, that's good. End of turn report, we are plus 2475, that's good. Faction announcements. Hero's death. Taylor Model died in East Poland. Virginia expands, Ernst Dissel, famous warrior plus one. Construction report, we have new ports in Rouen, Brussels and Bordeaux. And in Warsaw we have a small park. Recruitment report, we have new troops in many cities, including Messerschmitt 109, Stukas, Salty Infantry, Riflemen. Alright, lots of planes, that's good. War declared! Chinese Republic! That is nationalist China. They have declared war against the Japanese Empire, our ally. Enemy army routes. Walter Graf, yeah. Continue expands, Walter Graf, that's good. So we have an enemy army down here, three units of infantry, who cares? Could use more troops in that army. We want the planes to reinforce the army. this, I can't move this turn. We need some troops in Warsaw. So I think we can move these troops to the front. Seeing as how we had 3 units on their way there. 3 new rifleman units. Good, we have a full army. Ah, I merged it and now it's not a full army anymore. The mortars will be moved closer to Warsaw. You're gonna crush that army. You can't move anymore, alright. We can't advance any further into their land. We defeated all their armies here. With just one army. That's impressive. So, Erwin Rommel's army could move up towards Vienne. As for the rest, could see them some additional mechanized stuff. This army will move to Vienna as well. Rifleman army there. This unit could also move up. So we leave it there. This army will go to Vienna. Replace a few of our troops there. The assault infantry that we have here. We rather have assault infantry than riflemen in the army. So we moved out 5 units of riflemen from this army. Instead we will reinforce it with some Messerschmitt 109 planes there. Stuka bomber squadron. They already had a Messerschmitt 109 fighter unit. Use another one. Alright. And this unit could move to Munition. So now it's stronger, has some planes, giving us air superiority. Otherwise it's just the infantry. So while the land units can't do a lot of damage, they have the support of the planes there. We really need that many too. 5 units of fighters and 1 unit of bombers. Here we already had 2 units of bombers. Alright. We can't move anymore this time, so we will wait with anything there. See the fleets. They could move. Shit. The Great British Fleet is here. We are going to fight the battle. Jesus Christ, look at the statistics. The U-boat fleet is totally not ready for that. All of these ships. Prince of Wales, 62 defense, 42 attack, charge bonus 1. Hood, 57 attack, 1 defense. So the Hood has better attack, but better defense. Yeah, it has better defense too, alright. We won't attack actually, we're gonna retreat the fleet if we can. Alright, I need to speak to you Italians. They want to save the game first. I will have an updated map of your territory so I can see what you own currently, if you have lost Africa.
Left click on the listed offer and demand items to create a proposal. Left click on an item in the proposal to remove it. A balanced or very generous treaty proposal is likely to be accepted.
So, we have some updated information on the Italian map. They still hold Tripoli and they hold Addis Ababa and Mogadishu. They lost Benghazi a while back and they also lost Tunis that we gave them. The British are holding Benghazi and the Americans are holding Tunis. Have some riflemen there and other stuff. Assault infantry, Corsair fighter planes. Alright. We have forced the Soviets back into Poland and into Belorussia. They might still attack from this front and we don't have a lot of troops here. We have a bomber plane, a bomber squadron there. Alright. Can't forget the Norwegian garrisons there. Moving in the troops here. We move the fleet so it won't be attacked by the British. We boarded almost an entire army of assault infantry and some riflemen. Another assault infantry unit there. We'll replace one of the riflemen. I will take a look at it again. Alright, we have one unit of riflemen here. We will replace the riflemen unit with the assault infantry here and move the riflemen unit to Oslo. Because the population order is bad there. We move that unit up. It will also go to Oslo. Speak to the Soviet Union. If they have changed anything on their map.
Left click on an item in the proposal to remove it. A balanced or very generous treaty proposal is likely to be accepted.
This is their updated map. So Turkey has 4 regions from the start and then they got 2 from us, so they have 6 regions now.
click on the listed offer and demand items to create a proposal. Left click on an item in the proposal to remove it. A balanced or very generous treaty proposal is likely.
Updated information. Turkey is still in control here. So Turkey is still holding Greece. Bulgaria. Let's go to Bulgaria as well and update the information. Like in Rome, that we can talk to many or speak to many at the same turn, as long as we can reach them. So we updated the information here. Bulgaria is holding Belgrade still. And it seems Hungary is still in control of Budapest. Portuguese have moved back their troops from Bordeaux. Have a Stokes mortar artillery unit and some Hurricane British planes there. Their own version of the British Hurricane planes. They have those planes just like Finland. Take a look at the building queue. When I think about it, you could move some troops first. Riga, we have some Stukas. We need them there to defend in case Riga is attacked. Warsaw, we had some riflemen. Stettin, we have planes. Good. We'll move these planes to Warsaw. How is this army looking now? I see. Move this army up a bit. Move to Warsaw with this force as well. Had a plane in Berlin as well. Move a lot of planes to Warsaw. Amsterdam had some planes. Move a new bomber plane down to München. Or München. Alright, and in Frankfurt we had some bombers. Could also move. Here we had a unit of planes as well. Move them outside of Prague. That's it. Now let's take a look at the construction. You're still building the big park here. 80% completed. Only one turn left now until it's done. Civil building. Civilian building. In Brussels, we could build a small tank factory or a mortar training ground. I will build a small tank factory, then we will be able to construct Panzer Ones there. That's what we will do there. In Rouen, medium caserne. It will enable us to recruit assault infantry and scout snipers. Or a small tank factory. Or a mortar training ground with Stokes mortar. I will go for the tank factory. In every city. Here we aren't constructing anything. Here we could go for the something else, but I will go for the small tank factory here as well. You need tanks. Tanks and planes. Alright. Now it's time to recruit some troops. So in Berlin, we will continue with recruiting some planes. Go for the Stukas. Hamburg, we could go for the Messerschmitt 109 fighter planes. Oslo, we will continue with recruiting SLT infantry. In München, we will go for the Stuka. In Frankfurt, we will go for the Messerschmitt. Amsterdam, we are already constructing some Stuka bombers. In Brussels, we are constructing Messerschmitts. Paris, we are constructing Stuka. Rouen, we are constructing Messerschmitt 109. Bordeaux, we are also constructing said Messerschmitts. In Riga, we will construct the Rifleman. In Warsaw, we could use a unit of Messerschmitt 109 fighter planes. Vienna, we will get another unit of assault infantry. In Prague, we will get a new unit of Stuka. Stettin, we will get a new unit of Messerschmitt. And in Copenhagen, we will get some assault infantry. And we're done here. I'm sure the fleet will be attacked by the British when I click next time. So we can't attack with the two armies here, and the other armies are not at the front. Let's look at our agents. We have a diplomat outside of Moscow, we have used him already. Another one outside of Sofia, or Sofia, Bulgaria. We have Alfred von Kachler here. French state, which Italian Empire. Let's talk to the Portuguese. We're moving the diplomat. The spy has already moved. Alright. Next turn. Riga revolted. Alright. The British didn't attack me on the seas. We have a revolted in Riga. Lots of rebel infantry there. Let's retreat the garrison. We'll do this. Planes will move towards the army. General Gottfried Galen will move towards Warsaw. Diplomatic information: the following factions are now at war with each other. Romania have declared war on Turkey. Turkey has declared war on the Italian Empire. So my plan worked. They started war against each other. Construction report. In Berlin we have a new big park, in Frankfurt we have civil headquarters, and in Amsterdam we have civil headquarters. Recruitment report. We have new assault infantry, new Messerschmitt 109 fighter planes, new Stuka tactical bombers, and some riflemen. End of turn report. We are minus 1549, that's not good. Civil revolt in Riga, yes. So, if I understand correctly, Romania have declared war on Turkey here. Turkey has declared war on Italy. Yeah. So the Turk army, they have Devoitin fighter planes, French fighter planes. They are not that bad. And fighter plane from 1940, and they have some riflemen and some cavalry. That's what I can see. They are equal in strength to the Bulgarians and the Romanians and the Hungarians, yeah. But the Hungarians have unique tanks, while the Romanians have the French tanks, and the Turks have like German tanks and Italian tanks and the worst ones, and then the Bulgarians, the Italians, the Italians have unique stuff too, yeah. So the Turks did attack Italy. They only had riflemen here, one unit of scout snipers, one unit of anti-tank guns. All right, and then they have family member, and two units of cavalry, one tank unit, the Fiat 3000. Turkey also has that unit, and they have the Panzer IV, their best tank. Armored officer's car is the bodyguard of Ugo Cavaliero. Right. They aren't attacking the capital here. British diplomat here. Could speak to Britain. Get their map information. And they'll get ours. Makes sense that both factions should have map information. Alright. So the Vichy French are still in our territory. Three units there. How many troops do they have here? Three units. Five units in the city. Four units in Kiev. Up here they have some more troops. Not that many, three units. Half an arm here under Konstantin Petrov. Konstantin. Right. Here they had some greater stuff. Alexander Petrov is down there. Right. Our fleet, what should we do with it? We have no ports here. Our nearest port or the French port over there. Try to move there. Seems the Soviet advance has stopped for the moment, but they have huge numbers of settlements here. We need to invade them. I think we will let them take Riga now when it's held by the rebels there. But our army is here. Did we lose one of our armies or something? Ferdinand von Bock, there's the army I was looking for. He can move straight towards the front. Stokes mortar there. So we filled out that army. Let's move the other general back. So we filled up their troops there. Had a full army here, all right. Seven SS units. Don't think we need seven SS units there. So we got another plane unit into the army. And Erwin Rommel start to move towards Warsaw as well. Also move up. Under Gunter Alterbum. Then we will move out some assault infantry here. There, so we get plane unit as well. So we don't have any planes there. Let's move two units of planes to the army here. Frank didn't have anything like that either. Not Berlin either. In Hamburg have infantry. Amsterdam had a plane unit in Amsterdam. That's nice. Let's move to München with that one. Alright, let's move out the other unit. Stukas there. The army will be much better with the planes. Alright, in Brussels. I don't know if we should move anything there. One unit of Stukas could be moved. Bristol. unit of fighter planes could be moved there. So this fighter unit, fighter plane unit could be moved to the army. And they could move on forward. Alright, and we move the infantry into that city of Prague there. We have a plane unit here. So one unit of riflemen could be moved out. Won't move anything from Paris. In Rouen we had one unit of fighter planes we could move. In Bordeaux I think we'll keep the unit there. Now about attacking. I feel like attacking, but can't attack this time. So we have two armies we are facing off against here. So we have clear air superiority. I'd still prefer if they are the ones attacking, otherwise they will just retreat. Alright, let's save the game. And fight more another time. I'm kinda tired of talking. Alright, thanks for watching. See ya.